Hello everyone, welcome to TechDBA. Here is another video on MongoDB, and today we are going to talk about replication in MongoDB. We are also going to cover step-by-step instruction to create MongoDB replication in VirtualBox setup. So what is MongoDB replication? MongoDB replication is the group of MongoDB processes that maintain the same data set across the servers. MongoDB replication provides redundancy and high availability to support in case of any outage with the primary instances. Replication increases the read capacity of MongoDB by routing all the select statements to the secondary instance. It also provides fault tolerance to manage the workload during issue with some nodes of MongoDB replica set. In MongoDB, the replication happens through operations log, which is called as oplog. The oplog is a special kept collection that records all the changes on MongoDB instance, similar to on-demand redo log in Oracle. MongoDB records all the changes on the primary oplog. The secondary members copy the primary oplog and apply these changes in an asynchronous process. All the replica set members contain a copy of oplog in their local .oplog.rs collection, which allows them to maintain the current state of the database. In MongoDB, the secondary instance can get the missing oplog data from another secondary instance to get in sync with primary. Now, let's look at the members of MongoDB replica set. First is the primary instance where all write operations happen. The secondary instance having asynchronous replication from primary instance and can be elected as primary in case of any outage. Next is an arbiter. Arbiter is used only for voting purpose to eliminate the split brain situation. Arbiter doesn't hold any copies of data. We have different types of secondary instances. First one is a delayed secondary, which always maintains a certain lag from primary, which will be used to restore during any data manipulation error on the primary instance. As there is a lag, delayed secondary cannot become the primary. Priority zero node, which is used for load balancing for read operations, but this node can never become the primary instance. The hidden node, which is similar to priority zero, but this will be used for DBA maintenance operations and will not be visible to the application team, and it cannot be become the primary as well. In MongoDB, the failover is automatic and there is no manual intervention needed. There will be heartbeat between all the nodes of replica set. In case of primary instance is down, the heartbeat will fail between primary and secondary instances. Immediately after, the election begins, and the instance having higher vote count or the latest copy of data from production is elected as primary, and the other instance will replicate the data from the primary instance. In case, if the failed node restarted and joined the cluster, internal resync will happen and the node will be converted into a secondary instance and the replication will continue. Now, let's begin our setup of MongoDB replica set. Before we begin, if you haven't watched my previous video on MongoDB installation, please view the same and get your MongoDB standalone installation ready. You can also refer my blog site techdba.wordpress.com to change the host name and IP configuration. We are going to deploy a 3-node replica set with primary, secondary and arbiter. We will clone MongoDB server created and enable the replication. Then we will add an arbiter and simulate the failover scenario. Our primary server is MongoDB01 and its IP address is 192.168.78.51. In the initial setup, we have configured MongoDB as a standalone instance. To convert this instance into a replica set, we need to update /etc/mongod.conf file with some additional parameters. Open the configuration file with the VI editor and update bind IP as 0.0.0.0. This disables the IP binding so that the connection from secondary instance can be connected with the primary. On a production system, instead of zeros, we will provide the IP address of all secondary servers with comma separated. Next, let's uncomment the replication option and add REPL set name as testing RS. This is the name of the replica set, and all the members of the replica set must have the same REPL set name at their configuration file. Save the file and start the MongoDB process using service MongoDB start. You can check the status of process using ps-ef command. Let's clone the primary server MongoDB01 to secondary server MongoDB02. Shut down the primary server and select clone option. Provide the new name for the machine and update the location to keep the VDI files. Select full clone and click clone button. Once cloning completed, we can see two machines on the VM. Let's start both the machines. Once the server boot up completed, log in with username as osboxes and password as osboxes.org. On the cloned machine, the server name and IP address has to be reconfigured, as it will retain the old values. Launch terminal application and check the IP configuration of the machine using ifconfig-a command. On this cloned machine, you can see that the IP address is not configured. So let's invoke the network setting and assign the IPv4 address. Provide the IP address as 192.168.78.52 and the netmask as 255.255.255.0. Disable and enable the network and check the IP address again using ifconfig-a. Now you can see the new IP addresses are taken into place. Once IP addresses are assigned, try connectivity between the servers using a ping command and ensure they are connected. Now let's update the hostname of the cloned machine from MongoDB01 to MongoDB02. Let's give set hostname ctl command with the new hostname, which is MongoDB02. Check if the new hostname taken into effect and reboot the server. Let's start MongoDB process on primary and secondary servers. Review /etc/host file and /etc/mongodb.conf file and start the MongoDB process using service mongodb start command, both on primary and secondary servers. Issue ps-ef command to check MongoDB process is running. You can try to connect via Mongo shell. We are going to enable MongoDB replication between primary and secondary instance. Two screens on my left side are for primary instance MongoDB01 and the screens on my right is for the secondary instance, which is MongoDB02. Let's tile mongodb.log file under var log MongoDB location and connect with the Mongo shell on the other session. Now issue rs.initiate command on the primary Mongo shell. You can see the testing RS is the name of the replica set and we have specified both the servers' IP addresses and their port numbers, which is 27017. Once the rs-initiate command is successful, you can see the banner changed as primary on the primary instance and showing a secondary in the other instance. Whenever we initiate replication, the source database will automatically get replicated to the secondary instance, which means that there are no manual backup and recovery or a secondary database build is needed. For example, we have created the database training DB and the collection called training table on the primary, and we will check the same in the secondary instance. Before executing any command in the secondary instance, we must issue rs.slaveok command to acknowledge that we are running the query on the secondary instance and data may be inconsistent if we have a lag from primary. So execute showdbs and show collections and you can see the collection with the data is replicated on the secondary instance. Now let's try to insert some records on training table collection in the primary. On the secondary, we can see the same data gets replicated. So let's execute rs.status command to check the status of the replica set. Testing RS is the name of the replica set and you can see the primary will be specified as _id:0 and the secondary instance showing as _id:1. You can also check the instance status, last sync time and various other parameters of the replica set. Now let's add arbiter to replica set and simulate the failover scenario. The arbiter will be running from 27018 port on MongoDB02 server. To set up, we will copy /etc/mongodb.conf file to /etc/mongodb_arb.conf. Open the file with VA editor and update db path with var lib mongodb_arb and the log file to var log mongodb slash mongod underscore arb.log. Also update the port number to 27018. Save the file. Create the data directory var lib mongodb underscore arb and start mongod instance with mongod-config slash etc slash mongod underscore arb.conf. We can see the status using ps-ef command and connect with Mongo shell using the port number 27018. On the primary instance, issue rs.addArbiter command with IP address of mongodb02 along with the port number of 27018. Now let's issue rs.status command and we can see the arbiter added to the replica set. Let's connect with Mongo with the port number 27018 and we can see the Mongo shell showing as arbiter. Let's issue showdbs command and we can see only local databases exist. As arbiter does not hold any data and used only for voting purpose, the databases were not replicated. Now we have three node replica set with primary, secondary and arbiter instances. Let's bring down the primary instance and check how the failover process happens. The session on my top is primary instance and the two sessions below are belongs to secondary and arbiter instances. Now let's run rs.stepdown command which will force the primary database to become secondary. Now we can see the secondary instance automatically become as a primary instance. With one self vote and one vote of arbiter, the secondary instance got two votes and elected as the primary instance. Let's issue rs.status command and check the instance on the MongoDB became the primary instance and the other instance gets replicated. If we wish to fail back, let's run rs.stepdown command on node 2 and the instance on the MongoDB01 become as a primary again. So in MongoDB, the failover is completely automatic and there are no manual intervention needed. I hope this video finds useful to you. If so, like this video and subscribe to TechTBA. Very importantly, share this video with all your friend network. Thanks for watching. Stay tuned for more videos.